Welcome back to Horrors Worldwide. Today, I'm going to explain a supernatural horror film called It, released in 2017. Spoilers ahead. Watch out and stay safe. The movie begins in the town of Derry, Maine, where Bill Denbrough helps his little brother, Georgie, make a paper boat. It's raining outside, and Georgie wants to sail his boat in the rain, but Bill doesn't want to join him because he's too sick. Georgie hugs his older brother and runs outside to play. Georgie places his boat in the water on the street as it sails away. He chases after it, but the boat falls into the sewer. Georgie, afraid he'll lose the boat, sits on his knees to peek into the sewer. This is where he meets a clown who introduces himself as Pennywise, the dancing clown. Pennywise asks Georgie to take his boat back, and when Georgie reaches out to get it, Pennywise bites his arm off and pulls him to the sewer. 8 months later, in June 1989, we meet Mike Hanlon, whose grandfather, a butcher, is forcing him to shoot a goat in the head with a nail gun. When Mike struggles to do this, his grandfather takes the gun from him and does it himself. The scene changes, and we meet Bill and his friends, Richie Tozier, Eddie Kasprak, and Stanley Uris, excited on their last day of school before their summer break. Unfortunately, they run into a psychopathic bully at their school, Henry Bowers, who, with his goons, pushes them around and makes fun of Bill's stutter. We are then introduced to a girl named Beverly Marsh, who is bullied for rumored promiscuity. Beverly is seen smoking a cigarette in a cubicle in the girls' bathroom when a group of girls bully her and call her names. When leaving school, Beverly meets the new kid at their school, Ben Hascom, and signs his yearbook. In the next scene, Mike goes to the butcher shop to make a delivery. On his way there, he sees Henry's car and, scared, rushes into an alley. He then hears screams coming from behind a door in the alley and sees burnt children's hands reaching out from behind, looking like they're trying to escape the burning furnace inside. The door opens and Mike sees Pennywise for the first time. Mike is then almost run over by Henry's car and runs away. Stanley, being Jewish, is then studying for his bar mitzvah. As he enters a room, he covers his eyes so that he doesn't see a painting he's scared of. The painting falls, and when Stanley places it back on the wall, the distorted face in the painting is missing. When he turns around, it appears in the form of a woman in the painting, at which Stanley runs away. In the next scene, Ben is at the library, researching Derry's history. Through this, he learns about chilling disappearances and events that have occurred in Derry in the past, most involving children. He then sees a red balloon which he follows, leading him to the basement where he sees Pennywise in the form of a headless man and flees. Bill is still hurt by Georgie's disappearance and believes he's still alive, so he and his friends go to the sewer to look for him. There, Bill finds a shoe belonging to Betty Ripsum, a girl who had recently disappeared. On his way home from the library, Ben gets attacked by Henry and his friends. Ben manages to escape from the bullies who chase after him. Ben then falls into the river near the sewer where Bill and his friends are. The boys help him up and bring him to safety. Patrick Hockstetter separates from his friends and encounters demonic-looking children in the sewer. He tries to escape but meets a dead end where Pennywise appears and devours him. Bill and his friends then go to the pharmacy to help Ben, who is badly hurt. There, they realize they don't have enough money to buy the things they need, but meet Beverly, who helps them out. Beverly then returns home where her father, who abuses her, unsettlingly talks to her, triggering her trauma from the abuse. Beverly goes into her bathroom and aggressively cuts all of her hair off. While Eddie passes the abandoned house on Nightbolt Street, he gets scared and drops his pills. When he reaches to pick them up, a malformed hand reaches out, revealing a leper. The leper chases Eddie into the yard, and as he reaches the fence, he sees Pennywise, who tries to lure Eddie towards him, but he escapes. Beverly, sitting in her room, finds a card from Ben in her backpack, which she thinks is from Bill. She smiles, reading the card, when she hears the sound of children whispering from her sink. She appears the sink and looks into it. That's when clumps of hair covered in blood reach out and start grabbing her. Blood then gushes out of the sink and covers the entire bathroom. Beverly's father enters the bathroom to see Beverly horrified, but doesn't see the blood. The scene changes to show Bill, who is woken up by a leak in the roof due to a thunderstorm outside. Bill wakes up to put a bucket under the leak when the door to Georgie's room opens. He sees Georgie in his yellow raincoat running around, at which he's shocked, and follows the sound of Georgie's footsteps into the cellar, which has been flooded. Georgie steps out and invites Bill to join him, saying, "We all float down here. You'll float too." He then continuously repeats, "You'll float too," until his face deforms and Pennywise emerges from the water. Pennywise tries to capture Bill, but Bill escapes. The next day, Beverly calls the boys to her house to show them what had happened. The boys can see the blood, and all of them clean the blood-covered bathroom. As the kids ride their bikes after leaving Beverly's house, they see Henry's car and Mike's bike on the street. They think that he might be in danger and leave their bikes to go save him. There, they see Henry and his friends hitting Mike, and Beverly throws a rock at his head, allowing Mike to escape. Henry then insults Beverly, which enrages Ben, who throws another rock at Henry's head, starting a rock war. The losers outnumber Henry and his friends and manage to save Mike, who now also joins the Losers Club. Mike tells the rest of the kids that his grandfather thinks Derry is cursed, and that bad things happen because of one evil thing. The kids then describe what they saw and conclude that they all see a representation of their fears. Richie is the only one who hasn't seen anything, but tells everyone that he has a fear of clowns. The kids then go to Bill's garage and look at a map of Derry using a projector. They conclude that it lives in the Well House on Nybolt Street. Then Eddie, panicking, has an asthma attack and tears the map off the wall. The projector starts to work on its own and shows pictures of Bill and Georgie with their parents, but Pennywise's face slowly appears in place of their mother's. They knock the projector down, and eventually, Pennywise comes out of the projector screen and tries to grab the kids. He disappears when they open the garage door. The kids then decide to go to the Well House on Nybolt Street to confront it. Bill, Richie, and Eddie enter the house while the others stay outside as lookouts. Inside, Richie sees a missing poster of himself, at which he freaks out, but Bill reminds him that it's not real. Eddie gets separated from his friends and falls through the floor, breaking his arm. Bill and Richie are faced with three doors from which they have to choose to find Eddie. One door reveals a girl with the lower part of her body cut off, and the second door leads them to the room where it is about to kill Eddie. Then it turns to Bill and Richie and is about to attack them when Beverly puts a spear into its eye, and it retreats to the well where he resides. Eddie's mom, enraged, forbids the kids from coming close to Eddie, and the rest of the group also divides, too terrified to confront it again. The scene changes to August. Henry, using his dad's gun, shoots at random objects with his friends. He then asks his friend to hold a cat so that he can shoot it. Just before he pulls the trigger, his dad finds Henry using his gun and gets mad. He shouts at Henry and shoots at the ground next to him, causing him to shiver with fear. Henry, deranged, finds a knife in his mailbox, which has a red balloon attached to it. He goes inside of his house where Pennywise appears on the TV, encouraging him to murder his father. Henry does this by stabbing his father in the neck. Beverly returns home where her dad attacks her for hanging out with a group of boys. Beverly retaliates and kicks him in the face and runs to the bathroom. When her dad enters the bathroom, she hits him in the face, killing him. Beverly is just about to leave when Pennywise appears and grabs her neck. Bill then goes to Beverly's house where he sees "You'll die if you try" written on the wall in blood. He realizes that she's taken by it and makes amends with the rest of the group to go save her. The boys go to the well house where they find the well where it resides. They climb down a rope into the well, but before Mike can climb down with them, Henry appears, pulls the rope out of the well, and fights Mike. Mike pushes Henry into the well, who falls to his death. The boys then realize that Stanley is missing. They find him with it in the form of a woman from the painting, eating his face. When it sees them, he retreats. The kids go deeper into its lair and find a room full of little kids floating. There they see Beverly floating as well. They pull her down and Ben kisses her to break the trance it has put her in. Georgie then appears and tells Bill he missed him and wants to go home. But Bill comes to terms with the death of Georgie and shoots him in the head with a nail gun. Georgie's body then changes into Pennywise, who attacks the kids. The kids fight him until Pennywise has a hold on Bill. He gives them two options, that either all of them die or they leave Bill with him. They refuse to leave Bill with him, so they fight Pennywise, who turns into their worst fears, one by one trying to scare them. But they fight him and eventually no longer fear it. It becomes powerless and shivers with fear. Just before Bill lands the fatal blow to its already cracked skull, it escapes into the well. The scene changes to September. The kids gather and swear a blood oath to return to Derry 27 years later, if it were to ever return. They say their goodbyes and one by one, they leave until only Bill and Beverly remain. Beverly is moving to Portland, and before she walks away, Bill runs up to her and kisses her.